Hello guys, welcome to our first club. I don't think I've ever started a video without saying, "Hey guys, it's Moo Moo." So
Hey
I
guys,
did
it's
that.
Moo Moo.
Hey guys, welcome to the club is what I said. Who's nervous? For some reason we are, which is so crazy. We've been like, well, I'll tell you why we're nervous. We're nervous because of email. If email was fixed, we'd be okay. But email is not 100% fixed. Some people are getting them, some people aren't. So we're going to make some tweaks to our processes going forward just to be sure we're good.
Can I tell y'all, email's stupid.
It's crazy right now. It really is. It's just crazy. So, but we're going to get it all worked out. So who's here for a relaxing, fun time? That's what we're going to do. We're going to relax and have a good time. If you've never seen Club before, here's the deal. Club is free to all who want to join. And you'll be like, it doesn't make any sense, my mate. It's free and you stream it live on YouTube and everybody can see it. Yes. But in order to get the prep work instructions and in order to participate in our make-in mails, which we'll be doing at the end of the month, you'll want to join the club to make that happen. Okay. Because that's where all the information is going to come from. So what did that say? I don't think I got any emails. Okay. So here's what I'm going to do to get us started. I'm going to show you, in case you're coming for the first time and go, there's a club, I'm going to show you how to join it, okay? So, and I'm going to show you what it's all about first. That's where we're going to start, and then we'll make our project together. The project is easy and fun, and you're going to love it. All right, so what you can see on my screen, I'm going to scroll this a little bit. Everybody see this? This is our website. This is maymayevents.com, okay? This site is where you'll go to join the club. So to get any information on the club site, this is how you have to do that, okay? You're going to go to maymayevents.com and you're going to click on online classes. See how we have the in-person classes and the online separated? Click on online classes. And then I want you to go down here and click join the club. If you have not joined, this is what you do. When you get here, it's going to give you a breakdown of how the club lays out, okay? I'm going to go over it real quick. We are so excited you want to join the club. To capture your email address and information needed for future projects in the club, we need you to add this free product to your cart and check out. This product is free. See that it's $0. There is no shipping because we aren't going to ship you anything. What happens is you put this in your cart and you check out like you normally do. You do need to create an account on this site. Maymay Events and Maymay Made It are separate sites. If you don't have an account here, it doesn't know you, okay? So make yourself an account. When you check out, you're going to get an email. That email is working. Don't worry. That one is working. It comes from a different server. It's doing just fine. When you get that email, it's going to have your password for the club, which we're going to go into in a second because I want you to see how it works, okay? All right. Each month in the club, we'll make a fun project together. That's what we're going to do today. On the first Thursday of each month, we will create a post with all of your prep work and link to the video on the Clubhouse project page, which we're going to look at in a second. Don't worry if you've never seen it, okay? This is the change we're making because I can't trust my email. When email starts working, we're going to email it and do this. But if on next time we're supposed to get together, you're like, I never got a link, you don't have to stress about it. You just go to the club site. That's all you got to do, okay? All right. On the third Thursday of the month at 10 a.m. on YouTube, we will do the project, okay? The email, or not the email, but what we put on the club site will include everything you need, okay? On the last Thursday of the month, we'll do a make and take project. I will upload the video, but I will post it to the Clubhouse. It will not be public, okay? And the project will be a challenging project for you to make and then mail to someone. Sometimes we'll do service projects together, okay? And then in the club, we have these live chat rooms for you guys. So you can chat together. So let me do, and four times a year, we'll do a Zoom hangout that you can read all of that. I'm not going to read it to you. All right, let's go back home. So let's say you've put the product in your cart and you've built a new account on this page and you've checked out. Now you got an email from us that gives you a password for this right here. Made It Club, right in the middle up here. Okay. Made It Club. I have already put the password in because I didn't want to type it on camera today. So I'm going to be able to go straight in. If you have not put your password in, you're going to have to put the password in to access what I'm fixing to show you. So when I click Made It Club, it pops up. Okay. This is our February club project. Going forward, every third Thursday of the month, it's the third Thursday we do these projects on, third Thursday of the month, there'll be a new post right here. Okay. This page is going to grow over time. And that post will be March Club Project 2024. And we'll make sure we keep it very similar so you can understand what's happening. Okay. So next month, you don't have to wait on an email. You're just going to cut it, and this will go live on that Thursday. Okay. That morning. So you'll click right here. And well, that's not true. It'll go live before then, but the link will be in there, okay, for that Thursday. So you don't have to stress about finding the link. This is where we're going to put it, okay? But once you join the club, this is the kind of stuff you'll get. You'll see that this is what we're going to make. Click here for the free PDF. Click here for the journal pages, et cetera, et cetera, to get you ready. This is where you get what you need to get ready for each month's project, okay? So again, if you're just joining, look for this in March, and that'll get you started. I'll probably post this March, around March 1st every month, so you'll be able to get all your prep work ready, but we won't have the link in it until closer to the time that it goes. This is kind of a rolling thing. I can update it anytime I feel like it. Like, I can go in there and add something new all the time. So we'll add the link closer to time for the class to start. Now let's go back. Now you've joined the club, and you're like, this is the place to be. Let's meet some friends. All right, you click here, and you can enter the clubhouse chat rooms. Go right here and click, or you can click the picture, either one. Now, this is where you can have access to these little places to chat. If you're going to do the monthly project, which is what we're doing today, you can click right here. And when you get in here, there's all these folks chatting and talking with each other. See this? And what you can do, okay, so like, let me show you. Like, good morning from Bradenton, Florida. Maybe you're in Bradenton and you want to meet Betty. You can come right here where there's like one comment. You can click on comment and you can add your own comments. Okay. So anyway, that's how you can chat with each other. Right now, we just have the basic rooms. We're going to add rooms as the year progresses. Okay. We have the this one, and we have Meet the Made It. So you can come right here and you can meet different folks. So like this one has 9 comments. This person's just checking in, telling us where she's from. So if you wanted to comment, you could come in here and comment. I don't think I'm signed in. Oh, it's freezing for me. Okay, so if you want to comment, you can comment on everybody's and talk back and forth and have a little chat. So those are always going to be available for you. I am considering adding a Facebook group because many of you prefer a Facebook group. Like, the vast majority of you prefer a Facebook group. Some of you don't, but this would give you an option here, but I'm considering it. So we'll talk about that as people desire it. Okay. All right. So that's how you join the club and how you get your information. And I know it's silly. You're like, man, it's free. Just put it out to the public. There's got to be some reason to join the club. So we try to keep some things just for you guys in there, even though it's free. All right. I am trying to do this new thing here. So let me remove that. Let me add this. Let me change this. There we go. All right. I've got that set for 3 people, and there ain't 3 people here. So let's fix it to 2 people. There we go. All right. Welcome in. Let's see what people are saying. Let's see what they're saying. We'll also let you know if there are items to purchase on your site. You and Tamitha have been in the chat, right?
I was sending a few more emails trying to let people know. Just go to YouTube.
Okay. All right. So let's talk about the project today. I'm excited about it. So this project came about because actually it was several iterations of this project before we found what we wanted. We were going to do a sewn binding, which we've done before, but for club, I want to try to do projects that are easy for you to be able to do. Like, I don't want you to have to go buy special things or anything. And the one we really like, the binding we really like, takes 4 needles. And so it was like, not everybody's going to have 4 needles, you know? Yeah. And I was like, how are we going to make this happen? Well, we figured it out. So if you're a club member, you would have been able to get your PDF early and print this out that tells you all the pieces that you need. And something I'll remind you of, because there's going to be a lot of housekeeping today. Now, after this, it won't be like this, but today we won't do this every time. Okay. But one of the things I want to tell you is I'm never going to give you here your score marks or gluing or any of that kind of stuff, unless it's something I need you to do ahead of time. Okay. I don't like to give you too much information because when I do, some of you get too far ahead and some of you don't get as far ahead. And then when we come to these meetings, we're lost. Everybody's at a different place. So we try to make it where we just level the playing field. Okay. And everybody comes to the same spot. So you'll see on this one, for example, the make it kit supplies that were suggested are listed here. So this is where we're going to put things like you'll want to have this handy when we get started. Okay. Here is your project supplies. These were the cuts you needed to prep. And you'll notice there's no instructions for putting it together. We do that here. Okay. And then down here, you'll see that it's telling you there's a free PDF for this project and you'll want to print it. This PDF is so cool. So Sylvia made this for me before she went out on back surgery leave. I can't wait for her to come back. We have so many things we need her to do. So we can't wait for her to come back. But she made this PDF for us that you can print and you get this free as a club member. This is one of the things you get access to as a club member. And it's free. You just sign up. It's silly, I know, but it's just the way for us to give it a little bit of a feel of a club. So this PDF is available to you. So if you're watching today and want this, just go sign up for the free club and you can get it right there on that page I showed you. Okay.
Also, instructions to sign up for the club are in the drop down. Tamitha has it all there. So if you haven't joined yet, just go to the drop down. You can follow the instructions and join us.
Tamitha just said it, but I'm going to say it too because I think it makes sense. Please don't share the password or the free printables. You had to go sign up for it. Let them go sign up for it. It really is a good thing for us to kind of have our community in one place. So don't share your password. Plus, I'll tell you this. If you think you can do this, don't do it. But we've blocked the password from chat. So we went into YouTube and told it the password cannot be put in the chat. So you're not going to be able to put it in. If you type the password, YouTube will probably block you. So don't type the password because we did do that this morning too. All right. Now, so before these meetings, when we get together, you want to gather your supplies, which is what this sheet is for. Let's look at our supplies for today. So first, I wanted you to do 10 PDFs. Now, in the future, let's talk about some best practices with PDFs. You are going to have to get used to your printer, okay? What it can handle cardstock-wise, what it can handle, how it needs to be labeled for printing. For example, I would always suggest, say, fit to page, because I'm going to build these to fit the page. So if your printer gives you the option before you print to say fit to page, you'll want to do that, okay? If you don't do that, a lot of times your printer will scale your project down, especially to fit margins. And we don't really want margins. We want it to go all the way out, and that gives us this clean center section. Now, if today we're starting to do this and you're like, some of my stuff is messed up, I'm not ready, whatever, don't stress. Hang out with us. Watch us craft. You know, get some tips and tricks. Honestly, if I was in the club, I wouldn't participate at the time we're doing it. I would sit back with my cup of coffee, watch Maymay create, and then I would go make it afterwards, okay? I did just talk about myself in third person. I'm getting too big for my britches.
Well... Susan says the printer was the hardest part. I printed hours and it was a learning curve. But once you figure it out, it does make it easier. Mm-hmm. And it's different for everybody. So I can't tell you, I mean, I can tell you how I did mine, but mine's not going to be the same as yours.
Also, best practices are this. Let's say your printer can't handle cardstock. Let's say you don't have a printer. Some people don't have a printer. I need one at home so bad. Like I keep saying, buy a printer. If you don't have a printer, guess what? USPS, the store, not the USPS, but the UPS store, other stores like, is Kinko's still in business? There are stores that'll do them for you.
FedEx store
will do them for you. And they're super affordable. And I can promise you this. I will never send you something with a lot of color because that's expensive. And anyway, even if I send you something with color, you can tell them to do it in black and white. We typically try to make our PDFs black and white in projects because it saves ink for us around here and for you. Yes. We are always going to do our best to try to save you as much money as possible. We just want the club to be fun. We're not trying to make you spend money. And every month may not have a PDF. This one needed it. It was the biggest part of the build, right? All right. Again, this is stuff we won't do every month. This is stuff we're talking about right now, okay, because it's new. Today's fresh. So you'll want to make sure you're always setting them to fit to page. Here's another tip. If it doesn't bother you, put it to draft and just let it print a lighter black and save ink, right? I wouldn't care about that. We try to save ink because we print, every time you place an order, we print your order out. So we use a lot of ink and a lot of paper. So I don't mind doing it on draft instead of saying best or photo or whatever. All right. Oh, your library, my library will print them. That's true. Your library will print them. And it's real easy to do because nowadays you can just go in with it on your phone. It's real easy to do. Okay. So there's that. Now you needed 10 of these. You needed them printed front and back. Okay. Because there were two PDFs, right? There was a front and a back PDF.
It's in one.
Oh, it's in one.
It's in, yeah.
I don't know how that
works. It has that pages, page one, and then you flip it over and that's page two.
Mm-hmm. So there you go. And you also needed for this project, I didn't even open the project and show, this is what we're doing. We're making this little book. It's super, super cute.
The PDFs are in the project information on the Made It Club site. So if you log into the Made It Club, you click on the February project, the PDFs are in under the first like paragraph.
Okay. You're going to need two pieces of cardstock that are 4 inches wide. One is 12 inches tall. One is 11 inches tall. Okay. You're going to need 10 pieces. You should have this all. This is what you should have right now. It's 10 pieces that are 7/8 by 7 3/4. And then you should have your cover piece, two of those, your inside piece, two of those. All your measurements are on your PDF. I just thought about that. And then your two chipboard pieces. Now, I'm using my good old mat board chipboard that we carry in the store, but you can do this with cereal boxes, cracker boxes. You can glue some cracker boxes together if you want to be thicker. It doesn't matter. Use your scrap. Okay. Use your stash. All right. Let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to make the spine. Everybody ready to get started? Oh, while you're getting ready to get started. So get your two pieces like this and your scoreboard out. Go ahead and do that.
As far as the cardstock, it could be decorative. It could be whatever you want. It didn't matter. I did not specify on one of them that it should have been cardstock, not chipboard. And I know a lot of y'all asked. So next time I'll try to make sure that I have, if it's supposed to be chipboard, it's all chip, like separated better. But you know, we're learning too.
Also, yeah, we are. And one thing I want to tell you about too, whenever you see your instructions from us, if we say, and we did it here, if we say coordinating cardstock, what we mean is when you see this, like when you see this project, they just need to coordinate with each other to be a single project. See how those work together, but they could have been from five different paper packs. I mean, it doesn't matter, right? Just coordinate with each other. Now you'll notice here that Shannon made a specific point to point out that does not need to coordinate because it will be covered. So we were like, we didn't want you to think, oh, if I'm using this, I got to have pink chipboard. No, you don't. It's fine. We're going to cover
that's,
it up anyway.
That's why you could use a cereal box because you're covering the front and the back. So you wouldn't notice if it had print on it.
So if you see us say coordinating, that means it's going to show. And it needs to match what it, your main thing. But if we ever say like scrap or whatever, it can be whatever. Okay. All right. So maybe that'll help. So if we're learning. All right. So what you want to do is let's start with the 12 inch. So you have both of these pieces. I want you to get your 12 inch piece and your trimmer. Now, or your scoreboard. Now in our classes, what we like to do is I will say to you something like, okay, when you're ready, give me a one. And the reason we go ahead and give me a one, you guys. Okay. So you can understand how this works. The reason we do this is this reason. Instead of you having to take your keyboard and go, wait, please, I'm lost, or can we please get started? It's so much easier to go one, enter. You know what I'm saying? So here's what we do. When I say, when you're ready, give me a one, I also will say this, if you're lost, give me a two. All right. Now here's what happens when you type a two into the chat. Shannon catches it. And she sees your two and she will acknowledge you. And then she will wait for you to type your question or to clarify what you need. That's how we know to pause. That's how we keep everybody on track. Okay. So everybody giving all those ones. And then I'll probably sing a song like, here come the ones. Do-do-do-do. We like to do that. So just listen to what I'm saying. And sometimes we'll finish something. I'll go, when you're done, say finished. And then you'll just type one word in, and that keeps us on track, okay? Do not panic that you're going to get behind. If you do, it's a video you can have forever, number one. You can go back and forth all the time. And I will pause for you. If you hit number two, we will make sure your question is answered before we move on, okay?
Now, if Meme is in the middle of telling something, mm-hmm. I'm going to wait until she's done. So don't think we're ignoring your two. If we don't immediately respond to you, we will get to you. I promise.
That's right. So it, like if I'm going, we're going to score here, da, 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 da. Whenever I get to the, okay, let's get that done. She'll say, okay, Mary, I see your two. Go ahead and type your question. We will not leave somebody behind. Okay. All right. Let's get started. Put your 4 by 12 inch piece into your scoreboard on the 12 inch side. Okay. I want you to score it every 1 inch all the way down. We're going to do this to both pieces. Every 1 inch. Also, this project is a simple project. They won't always be super, super simple, but I'm going to always try to make it something that we can complete 75 to 90% of in 2 hours. And I'm going to always make it a project where in the future or when we get done, it's something you can finish on your own and make sense. I'm never going to leave you with, well, we got that much done. That's all we can do. We're not going to do that to you. We're going to bring projects to you that you can complete. And if for some reason we find we can't complete it in 2 hours, we'll do a video separate. We'll hang out longer, whatever we need to do. Club is fun. Club is for us to hang out and chat and have a good time and craft together and glue paper. It's my favorite thing to do. Yes. Is that all? No.
Yeah, if anybody is watching and haven't received the password to get into Clubhouse, give Haley a call at the store and she can help get you in and get you all set up.
If you haven't gotten your email password, you need to make sure that maymayevents.com emails are not marked as spam in your email. All right. So we got these done. When you got your scoring done, give me a one. This is where I get to drink drinks because I get to, get some water, drink some of my coffee because I got water on this side. Right, I got coffee
got
on this side.
News from Miss Michelle Rowe. Let me know what's up, Miss Michelle.
Also, let me say this. I typically, for the sake of the video, I don't go back to the beginning. Okay. Live streams on YouTube now, you can scroll back. So if you get lost, if you are coming in late, you need to go back to the point where you came in and just let the video play from there. Okay. So it's not fair to everybody else for me to go back to the beginning and start everybody back over. But because of the way YouTube does it now, let's say you just got here and I've already got this scored, go ahead and scroll back to where I'm saying that and just let the video play from there and you'll be fine. You'll feel caught up at that point. Look at the ones. Here come the ones, do 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 do. Here come the ones, and I say, let's fold this thing, fold it.
Yes, both are scored at 1 inch, all the way down. So you'll have the 4x12 score at 1 inch all the way, and 4x11 score at 1 inch all the way.
All right, now what I want you to do is I want you to start accordion folding them. Hey, I did that pretty good this time. Here's what's important. If this is the piece you want to show in your book, I don't really care which piece shows, but let me show you. This is my spine. The floral piece is my spine. If you want this to show here, when you start doing your accordion fold, I want you to fold this up first. Okay. So I'm going to go forward. If that's the piece you want to show. Now, let me show you. This is not a cut apart on the back, but it kind of looks like it. So I'm going to let that hide because I don't really love it. So I want this to show. So I'm going to go up. Okay. Then I'm going to go down. We're mountain folding or accordion. Mountain or accordion, whichever way you say it. Did I skip a score? I skipped a score.
Miss Michelle, you are scoring every 1 inch.
Unless you're me and you skip one.
Then
you got to go back and do it.
You're supposed to score every 1 inch.
I messed mine up. I gotta fix it.
See?
I'm gonna have to scroll back and catch up where she's at. There we go.
It might not work for you.
All right, so it might not. Get fixed there. There. Pretend like it didn't happen.
Didn't happen.
See, in editing, we would clean that up. Did I skip a whole bunch of them? Was I just talking so much? Because there ain't one there either. I did. I just skipped it.
I bet those lines on that paper.
It's not great, but I did just skip it. Okay. So
you're not supposed to skip scores.
Don't skip
you're
every
to
inch.
Score every inch on both pieces.
Then I'm just going to creasy. All right. So you see, I have this one facing up. See that? Okay. Same thing over here. I want this end to face up. So I'll just start down here. Let me check my scores. All right. I feel those.
Yes. If for any reason you need to leave, this video is going to be here. So you can come back and watch it like any other Maymay video.
It'll stay up just like our Thursday nights, our Tuesdays. Yep. It'll always be there for you.
I did see a two, Joseph P. If you have a question, you can type it in.
Maggie said, move along. Nothing to see here. It's certainly no booby. Certainly no booby.
Whatever.
I love that. Move along. Nothing to see here.
We are good at boo-boos. Y'all just don't get to see them all because if we're recording, we fix the boo-boos before you see them.
We delete them. All right. Give me a one. No, actually, give me an A for accordion so I can know because some people are still typing ones from earlier. So give me an A for accordion so I can see that you're here. You can see I've got my two end pieces facing up. That's what's important.
Yes, Miss Andrea. We'll get Tam to start a playlist of the club videos so it'll be easier for y'all to go. If you're typing some twos, go on and type what your issue is.
Yeah.
And we'll go back and answer you.
Let me show you this. This end is facing up, right? The left-hand end is facing up. The right-hand end is facing up. The middle section, I've got one facing up and one facing down, which is exactly what we want. We've got to combine these together in a second. So that's what we're looking for. And listen, it's not a big deal. You can just change your scores. You can change your folds. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to get this accordion looking like this, the two end piece. This is the 12 inch, by the way. Get the two end pieces facing up. Okay. And on the 11 inch, I want you to get one end facing down and one end facing up. Can you tell that we cut that extra inch off? See, if we had that extra inch, we'd have one more going up, but we didn't need it. That's why you have a 12 and an 11. Yeah. Okay. So that's why that one's going down. And they're going to eventually lock into each other like this. So I want you to have them like this. Boo-boos are something we all do. Now, once you have them all like this, I'm getting a lot of A's. Once you have them all like this, I want you to take this section that's facing up on your left-hand piece, and I want you to apply glue. I'm just going to use Mark Glitter Glue. You can use your sticky tape here, whatever you want to use. So I'm going to apply glue. I have this whole inch to glue. This whole section can be used. So you see that? And then this is really cool. It's just going to sit. We're just going to sit them together. We're just making one big long accordion piece. What I do like to do is get that guy in there as far as it'll go and then stand it up on my work surface and press it. What that does is it levels it out. If you're not careful, you'll end up with something doing like this. So that's why I like to do that. And then you can just squeeze that together. So see how we just created this and both of my end pieces go up. And now we're like,
the A's were just if you got your accordions done.
Don't forget your glue tip to start in the middle. Yeah, that's a good tip, and I forget it a lot. It's a great tip if you can remember it. For those of you who don't know.
Kind of like using your glue bottle and putting your pin back in.
Yeah, if you can remember it. For me, because when you first start squeezing, I think we all do this, squeeze a little heavy when we first do it. If you'll start kind of here instead of at the end, you don't end it with that blob. And I love the tip. It's just me remembering it to do it.
Yeah, the matching pieces are just cardstock. Supposed to be cardstock.
These pieces, your 4x11 and your 4x12. Does it say cardstock? Two matching pieces for spine.
Yeah, we didn't say cardstock.
We're learning. All right, we got that done. Let's move my scoreboard out of the way. We don't need it.
By we, I said me. Me missed it. And then Maymay read it and she missed it. But, you know, it happens.
You know how I read. All right.
Sorry.
Now, let's put this aside. Let's go away from this for a minute. Let's go get our PDFs out. Let's do some repetitive work. So you're going to need 10. And I think Shannon... gave me extra, so I'm going to count them out.
Just in case.
Let me say this. I'm going to do 10, but I'm going to tell you, you could do less or more. Okay. This will hold up pretty good, probably for at least twice this, I would think. Let's look. I mean, you can make it at least twice that thick. At that point, it's going to get a little bit unwieldy, I think. I don't know. 10's probably good. I mean, you get 10 projects to keep in here. What I would do is I would make one for paper. I would make one for folios, one for cards, one for, that's what I would do. And that way you can have less pages in here. But what we have to do now is we have to prep these pages to go over our spine. Okay. So I want to show you some things that I've got ready to show you to make it a little easier for you. Here it is. The first thing we need to do is just fold all these in half. That's it. We're just going to fold them in half. So the front of the page is here where it says project. That's the front of the page. You want that facing up. Okay. This is the back of the page. So what we want to do when we fold is we want to put this behind. So what you should have facing up when you fold is project directions and website inspiration. I'm going to do it again. So this is the front of the page and this is that back part. Okay. So when we fold, we want to have project directions and website inspiration facing up. And here's how you fold in half. Now you can go back to your scoreboard and use the edge. Like I'll show you, because this is a really good tip. If you struggle folding in half, push this into the edge of your scoreboard, push this over and fold. I'm not scoring this ahead of time. I'm not too stressed about it. This is a project that's just utilitarian for me to use. So that's how I'm doing it. And this is what you should end up with. Project on the front, project directions, websites and inspirations, notes on the back. That's how it should end up. Okay, let's do it again. So I'm going to take a piece and I'm going to make sure project is on the bottom side. Okay, project directions is on the top. I'm going to push it into my scoreboard and I'm going to fold it in half. You need to do 10 of them. When you've got all 10 of yours done, give me the number 10. Are we confident that I'm not going to fold one of these backwards? No. Because I get excited. My goodness, you guys. Look at them 10s.
I bet some of these people folded their papers ahead of time.
Probably. Hey, the first 10 10s get 10 gold stars. First 10
10s. Absolutely useless, but fun to collect.
Y'all, we had a meeting yesterday with some folks in our town, and I gave them all gold stars, and they were like, yay. It's a habit now. I give everybody gold stars. Oh, I messed that one up. I ain't going to stress. I'm going to keep going. Look at the 10s. Y'all are beating me. Dang. Oh, heck. If you get 10, you get 10 stars. How about that? When you're done, you get 10 stars. Everybody gets them.
It's all right, Miss Jean. You can come back later and catch up. You can just watch now. It's a fun project.
Creative Art Spark, that is very kind of you. We picked what we wanted on these pages. We kind of did some research and we're like, what do we want? And also, I don't write small. So we try to make it a little chunky. I have some project books that I bought that have little tiny skinny lines. And I wanted more space. That's what I was telling Sylvia. I need room to write. So that's why these look like that. All right. You got these done. We'll move on to the next step. So this is the front of the page. Okay. We'll zoom in a little bit. All right, this is the front of the page. We have to make a floating slice. What that means is we're not going to slice the whole page. We want to slice basically a slit to allow our spine to go through. Okay? So we have to do a little bit of math. But what I wanted to do for you is do this little diagram to make it make sense before we do it. Because this I think even for me, back when I first saw people kind of doing this, it intimidated me. I'm going to do it on my trimmer. That's what used to intimidate me, how people would do the floating lines on their trimmer. So I'm going to show you a couple of ways to do it, but I'm going to use my trimmer because it's super easy. And I'm going to tell you how that works. So we'll be making this floating slice. This black line represents my slice. See that? So I have already cut this page and I'll show you. Yes, you can put away your scoreboard or at least put it down where you can get to it. I don't think we need it again. I think we're done with it. I've already made the slice. See that? And that black line represents my slice. Now, the slice starts at 2 1/8 here. And let me tell you why it does. We're putting 1-inch pieces through here. I want this to make sense, so it'll be easy for you to assemble. this is where we're inserting these pieces right here, and we're putting this through. So we don't want them to be exact, because then it'll be too tight and we might rip our page. So that's why I did 2 1/8. That's where we'll start our score from the edge of the page on our fold line. I'm measuring on my fold line down 2 1/8. And then down here from the top, we would go to 6 3/8. So if you're going to cut, with a blade, you want to lay your ruler on the fold line that you've already done. You want to come down to 2 1/8 on the fold line, and you want to cut down to 6 3/8 if you're going to use this. Okay. That's how that works. If you're going to do it like me on your trimmer, you're going to put this in the trimmer, put the blade on the fold line, start at 2 1/8, and go to 6 3/8. Okay. So it's whatever works for you. You're going to cut in the valley. That is correct. You're going to cut on the fold. See how mine is on the fold? I'm not even going to start cutting until everybody understands what's happening. We're creating that. We're doing this. And I did this one so you could see it. So where you folded, we're going to cut. Okay? So you're going to come down 2 1/8, and you're going to go down to 6 3/8. Now here's how I'm going to do it with my trimmer, so I can show you how that works, okay? So I'll bring my trimmer over, and remember, guys, don't panic right now that I'm getting started. We've got 10 of these to do. I'm going to walk you through 10 of them. Don't panic. There is no panicking in club. Got it? No panicking. Not allowed. If you panic, I take stars away.
You panic before club.
You panic before club. That's what we did. So I can clearly see my fold line. See it right there? So I will put that on my cut area right there. Now, on the side of your trimmer, there's a ruler. It's real handy. And your blades all have these little marks, all these little hash marks, lineup marks, guide marks. Like there's one right there. There's one on this side. There's one right here. There's one right here. So what I'm going to do is, see how I'm not laying my blade down? See how my hand is keeping that from happening? I'm going to roll this up until my 2 1/8 inch mark and my little guide are meeting each other. It does not have to be perfect. We cannot cry.
No,
we just don't do it. We can cry over emotional things. Like my mama used to say, like, if you're a boy, you can cry over football and your mama. Those are the two things you're allowed to cry over. So we can cry over some things. So we'll put this little guideline to 2 1/8. Okay. And then I'm going to sink that in. So it's going to sink into my score, to my little score mark. Now, let me say this to you. Perfection is not needed. This is not a project that needs perfection. It just doesn't. So any little minute thing that's off, I can show you how to take care of it in a minute. No big deal. So I've sunk my blade in at 2 1/8. Now I'm going to go ahead down here, and I can see that 6 3/8 is 1/8 past 6 1/4. So a quarter is 2/8. So if I want 3/8, I need to go 1/4 + 1/8. Okay. So if you need to, put yourself a little mark right there. Put yourself some yellow tape. If this will help, come right here. That yellow tape's too wide for me. Let me get a little piece. Come right here and just go 6 3/8. Right there. I can just put my little piece of yellow tape there, and I'll know where to stop. Okay? So I've got it sunk in. I'm going to hold my paper and everything, and I'm going to scroll down till my blade, my little guideline, reaches 6 3/8. This is not as scary as, like, back in the day. You're just going to tell me to use my yellow tape. Back in the day, this was scary to me. I don't know why. I didn't like doing these what I call floating slices. But there we go. Not hard, right? The yellow tape is actually a good idea because it makes it faster. You know, even if I put this other piece.
Say I'd mark my 2 1/8 too.
Yeah. If I put this other piece up here, that'll make it super fast, but I need to not have it on the. Yeah, that's a good idea. I like it. Smart girl. All right. So I'm going to go here. I'm going to go to 2 1/8. I'm going to set my blade.
Okay, Susan Pulver says, hers is off the fold mark. How do I fix it?
just before you put your blade in, make sure you've lined your fold mark on your cut line before you sink your blade. Once you sink your blade, it won't wiggle. So I'm going to come right here.
Well, just a hint, if you don't have yellow tape, you can use washi tape. You can even use the sticky part of a sticky note.
Paper, painter's tape.
Any type of tape you have.
Frog tape.
If all else fails, get your Sharpie, get a colored Sharpie and go to it, because alcohol will erase a Sharpie off of the plastic.
A Band-Aid. What else is sticky? A fruit roll-up?
I have a fruit roll-up over there. You want to try it?
I would do it. Because I'd have to eat the rest of it.
Yeah.
Can we just use a fruit roll-up?
You can use whatever you have handy.
What else is sticky?
But if y'all don't know, you can write on some of these plastic things with Sharpies and then go back later and erase it with hand sanitizer. That's what I show y'all in my stitching class. We marked stuff.
Star stickers, your bubble gum.
Star sticker, your bubble gum. That will get really sticky. I don't suggest
you can
using
clean
your
that with
gum.
Hand sanitizer later.
You can, but it might be on your paper.
What about a postage stamp? It'd be expensive, but you could do it. You'd have to pay for it first.
Wow, this is...
Cheryl!
A boogie! That's gross. Frog tape is a type of painter's tape.
It's like a painter's tape. It's just green. I think it's just the green version of a blue tape. I don't know.
It's alien beautiful. Tape? That's super... That's like super sticky dedication.
I wouldn't use alien tape.
Super sticky dedication.
Is 2 1/8 the second notch on the ruler? If you're using a Tim Holtz ruler... To give yourself a reference, because down here it's a little different. But 2 1/8, there's your two. You're going to go over that little mark, that first mark, if you're using Tim Holtz. If you're using any other ruler, if they have 16ths mark, an eighth is 2/16. Oh, is it yellow? Frog tape is yellow. I thought it was green, y'all. Lip liners.
Oh, her frog tape is green. Her frog tape is yellow.
Lip liner would work.
Yes.
Eyeliner, for that matter. Chapstick, it'd be clear.
So, what have we learned from this?
That you don't have to have fancy tools. That's what we've learned.
You don't.
You know those things you put under your eyes? Those eye masks? Those would work?
I do not have those.
Bags. I have bags. Plenty of them. You know something else that would work? If you have that tape that pulls wrinkles, like if you put it on your face, like the Hollywood people use, that would work.
So goofy.
I'm coming up with all kinds of things that would work. Okay. You think the color references how sticky it is. That makes sense. Duct tape.
We have learned that we are silly. Thank you, Elizabeth. Yes, we have.
String. You could tie a string around it.
Oh, my goodness, y'all.
I feel like this has been worth it. If you've taken the time out of your day to do this, you've learned a lot.
You could use press and seal.
Press and seal. You might have learned that this is not the club for you. You might have learned that today.
Don't use boogies and gum. That is correct.
That's right. This is now cut. Okay, so all my 10 are cut. Now, here's what I want to tell you. In a minute, when we go to assemble this guy, if they're not just right, we'll deal with it then. But we've got our major cuts done. Okay, we are a creative bunch.
A cheese slice.
And it will be getting warm for me later.
Yeah, that's
love that. All right. When you have your accordion folded, you got your 10 pages folded, you got your 10 page sliced, give me... gum. Y'all thought I was going to say boogie. I said gum. Give me gum. When you're all to where I am. My pages are cut. My accordion's done. Everything's ready. Give me gum.
I'd like some gum.
I would like some gum myself.
Actually, no, because I still have coffee.
I want to do a cheese slice. I want to try doing it. And you know, the cheese slice would create like a little, like a ledge. You literally stop at the ledge. Gum. Shannon went away.
Yeah, it froze up and it won't let me back in.
You want a fresh invite? We think they'll help.
Yeah, try that, because I've been clicking on this one and it won't do anything.
Shannon!
I'm right here.
Shannon! Me. Listen, 90% of the time in the store, that's what you hear. Me going, Shannon! Shannon!
And then when Shannon doesn't answer, we go, Alan!
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 Shannon! That's what y'all need to do. Whenever she disappears from now on, just type, Shannon!
If you can do the voice, it'd be even better.
Shannon! I should put yellow tape in my purse. Jo says she just keeps it with her always. All right. Cloak of invisibility.
That is me.
All right, let's do this. Now I want you to get your chipboard pieces, whatever they may look like. Whatever they may look like. How do I want to tell y'all how to do this? You guys love precision. Did y'all know that about you? Y'all love precision. Some of y'all will be like, Mamie, won't need all that. But 90% of you guys want me to give you exacts. Did y'all know that? We've learned this. So this is an 8.5. Let me do some math in my head. I should have already done this, but I didn't think about that.
You need some paper for that?
Half of 8.5 is 4.25. That guy's 4. Forget this. Let's do this. 4.25. Okay. All right, here's what's going to happen next. We're going to create this kind of funny looking thing. Okay, we're going to take our two pieces of chipboard and these pieces that are, remember I told you I want them folded up? Here's why. I'm going to glue it down in the center of this chipboard on one side like this and then on one side like this. See how we're making like a bridge across the two? That's what we're going to do here. Okay, this is fixing to get super fun. Y'all are going to love this. So you're going to want to center this. You can put your chipboards together and just make sure you're putting them in the same spot, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one piece and I'm going to apply glue here to one little fold. Then I'm going to eyeball my center. I'm not going to stress about it. If y'all want to stress, stress. But you want to be down about 2 2⅛ inches, okay? 2 to 2⅛. That's what we're looking for. Actually, no, that's not right. Hold on. Don't measure yet. Let me check. Let me be right. If I go to 2 1/8, that's too high. So let's do, so 4 1/4 is the center. And I take 2 that way and 2 that way. 4 1/4 is the center.
What is the measurement on your other one?
Where's the center? And that's 4 1/4. I'm sure this is easy and I'm making it hard. So if I go 1, 2 1/4, and 6 1/4. So 2 1/4 should be where we're going. Let me double check it.
That's what Stargazer says.
That's what I said. Somebody's already got this. 2 1/4. That's where we're going. So let's just do that. Let's make a mark with a pencil 2 1/4 down. See, y'all are always better at math than me. I have to stop and make my brain function. Some people's just functions.
Well, let me tell you, Noah's homework last night was fractions. And some nights I can get it. Last night I could not get it. And we had to wait till Daddy got home.
Fractions. I can do pizza fractions. Pie fractions. Okay. Glue. This whole little flappy flap.
Flappity flap. Don't talk back.
And then 2 1/4 down from the top, place it to the edge. That fold. To the edge. Do not panic. I'm going to get this glue down. I'm going to pick it up and show y'all what I've done, okay? So all I've done here is I've glued my little robot arm.
And she is gluing this. It's actually on the outside. Not that it really matters yet, but...
It's on the inside. You glue this to the inside.
Oh, you glued it to the outside on the other one.
Well, I'm not this time.
Never mind.
Yeah, I put it to the inside because I was going to hide it with my paper. I guess it doesn't matter.
Yeah, you're hiding it with your paper.
Really doesn't matter. It's not, you're going to see it. So right here, see how I've got that glued down? Now what I'm going to do, so I don't have to measure again because I don't want to. I'm just going to put this guy next to it like this. I'm going to apply glue to my other end of my robot arm. I remembered my tip. Listen, please do not stress about this centering situation. Just get pretty close. We're not perfect. We don't do perfect. Have we forgotten that around here? Have we forgotten it? And then I'm just going to lift this up out of my way and stick it down. And I'm trying to make it where y'all can do it, but I really would just eyeball it and get it close. Okay. That looks good. That looks good. I like it. Glue that down. Again, 2 1/4 inches from the top is all you need to worry about. And it does not need to be perfect. So that's what we've done. We've glued, we've bridged our pieces together just like that. That's all we've done. Pretty good, right? I like it. Now the fun part. I love this part. I tell you what, when you've got this done, give me a B for bridge. B. B.
No, my computer did not die. It just froze up.
Who said they're stressing? What?
Joe Terry is stuck on I-40 at a complete standstill.
Okay, stress about that.
So I think she's stressing about that.
Stress about that. No, don't. I mean, don't stress. What? You know what? If you're stuck there, God wants you stuck there. That's it. If you're stuck there, there's a reason. You said, that was fun. Not. The fun part's coming. All right. Here's what we're going to do next. We're going to go back to our folded pieces. And remember, don't worry. I got to do 10 of these. So you're not going to get lost. Okay. Except we don't want to use the pieces I did not cut open. Go to your folded pieces that you cut. Okay. And remember, this is going to be down. Project down. Okay. Project directions up. Now, where this hole is, it's going to go on top of this one fold. So I'm going to turn this where you can see it. I'm going to take Shannon, come hold one of these. Honestly, this will make this so much easier if you'll just hold one, because I don't want anybody to be confused. All right. So with your accordions, every page is going to take 2 folds.
No, you're going to get 1 mountain.
Okay, mountain. I was trying to think how to say it. So every one mountain goes inside. So each one of these mountains is going to hold a page. Okay. So you're going to take 1 mountain and push it together. You don't have to glue it. Actually, don't glue it. We don't want to glue it. So you're going to push 1 mountain together. Okay. Thank you. I think that
helped.
You're
very welcome.
So with that 1 mountain pushed together, I'm going to take my folded piece and find my slit and put that mountain through that little slot that we created. I have a little wiggle room, and that's good. We wanted that. I can kind of slide up and down, okay? So 1 mountain went through 1 slice, and you want to do that all the way down, every mountain.
I need a Shannon to help me some days too, y'all.
So 1 mountain all the way down. Remember, project directions is up. We're going to fold that to the middle, and we're going to put 1 mountain into that slice. So go in. Every one. Now, you may find that some of these are going to be a little tight. Just make an extra slice. You shouldn't have to. I gave you some wiggle room to make it easier. So I'm putting a page on every mountain fold.
So I'm guessing Auntie Glitz, you were totally singing Sound of Music, Fold Every Mountain. Kind of Climb Every Mountain.
Also, don't worry about the lineup yet. Don't worry about this too much yet. We'll tap all that into place, okay? But every mountain is going to get one. The biggest thing is to make sure project directions is on the inside.
Because if not, you have to take it apart like Mama did the first time.
Which it won't matter. It's easy to do. Trust me, I've done it.
That's why we love this project.
Great. Now I'm singing Climb Every Mountain.
No, you're folding every mountain.
Fold every mountain.
Are you following
and by the way, it's not going to feel very sturdy right now.
Nope.
It will when we finish. It's going to feel good. Then you'll be like, wow, that's cool. And you'll be able to make these for everything. I think this would be such a cool, oh, this might need to be Addie's birthday project. She could do this easy. This wouldn't be hard. And if not, parent could sit and help. We want to do this with everybody. I was telling Taylor about it too. And Josh, I was like, please tell them we have a project ready for the span.
We're ready.
We want to do this one. Get that one on there better. All right. When you've got all yours done, mine are not done. But when you have all yours done, because I know some of y'all are so much faster than me, go ahead and give us Cliff for mountain. Cliff. We're not going to fall off of one today.
Nope, we're going to jump.
That's before the show. By the way, stick around. We're going to do a giveaway at the end. And if you're watching the replay, you'll have an opportunity to win too. Just check. Just wait. It's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to do that in a few minutes. See, look, they're always faster than me.
They are.
This is my last mountain. All right. Once you got them all on there, just kind of do this number. Just kind of tap it. See, I told you we'd get everything lined up. And don't worry that they're not perfect yet. We have to do this next, okay? So you can see that this is where we glued onto our chipboard. And now I'm opening the page up, okay? You want to pull out your little pieces, these 10 little pieces. Now, if you have a corner rounder, I think this is a good idea. I will show you. I'm going to grab my corner rounder. On your 10 pieces, I think I'll just do the quarter inch. Just on one side of them, my quarter inch cut is not good on this one. Well, maybe that was me because it worked fine then. So just on one side, you can corner around one side just to take some of the bulk out. Okay. And I want to do that. If you don't want to do that, you don't have to. Just hang out. But I'm going to take one side. It must be my hand up there because that one did it again. And I'm going to corner around that one side. I'm going to lay that down so you can see what I'm doing. I'm just corner rounding one corner. Let me show you something. If you're thinking, this is not fair, I didn't know about it. Look, I didn't use it here. This one is not corner rounded. My original is fine. I just want to corner round it because I think if you struggle with this next part, this will help you from struggling. Are we still fold every mountain?
I think they are folding every mountain somewhere. It's still in my head.
Getting some cliffs.
Yep, you got some cliffs.
I want to know what all y'all will use these books for. I really do think it would be fun to have one for card making. Or folios. The idea is when you're watching a video and you're like, ooh, I want to make that. You know, we always can save the videos digitally, but when we do that goes into our digital brain and we never really open it back up. That's just how we are. But if we have it like this, we're like, man, that's a project I really want to make. I want to make a page about it. Even if you just do a quick sketch or you print out a picture and stick it right here for you to remember what it is, how fun is it? And if you're somebody who maybe has given yourself a challenge to complete so many projects this year or something, you could give yourself this book to complete 10, you know what I'm saying? And go, I want to complete 10 projects this year and just go ahead and build them in here. I think it'd be so fun. Using it for the club is a good idea. For your quilting, I like that. A recipe book, this would be so fun for that. And I'm going to show you in a minute some of the functionalities of it, which I think are really cool. So if you're doing the corner rounding thing, you'll have two corners rounded, but one not. Okay. Here's how we're going to latch this thing together. So we've put that mountain up through the slot. We did not glue it, but so now we have like a tunnel. We have an open tunnel in our mountain. Okay. We're going to slide this into the tunnel. Now, this can feel a little bit tricky. So what I want you to do is before you start putting it in there, I want you to go ahead and use your fingers to make sure your page is pushed all the way down to give you as much tunnel exposed as possible. Okay? Because you do want to be able to use the whole tunnel. Then we're going to take this little slip of paper slide it in. And you'll see, if you did the corner rounding with me, why that's so cool. I want you to watch down here. Another trick. Don't push from back here. This is cardstock. It's going to bend. Come up close to the tunnel and just do baby pushes. Baby pushes will help. And that page is locked in. Isn't that neat? I love that. Now we're just going to do the next page. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to push it down so I have all the tunnel that I need exposed. Take my next strip, and I'm going to go into the tunnel. If yours is not showing, like if yours is not coming out like you want it to, you do have access it from underneath. Now, we don't use glue in this section. You do have access to it from underneath because the tunnel is open on the backside. But you should, if you do these baby pushes, be able to do this. And worst case, when it gets here, see how mine dropped down a little bit? All you got to do is pick it up here and lift it up and pull it.
The curves are facing up.
Yeah, face them up to make it go in easier. Isn't that neat? And you will skip a page. Like you'll have this one with one and then it skips and then it goes to the next one. And then I'm going to skip and go to the next one. All of your mountains should have, all of your mountains should have a strip in the tunnel.
Yes. If you are not a member of the club and you want the PDF printouts, you can go to the May events page and join the club. It's in the dropdown of this video, and it is free. You just have to sign up and you will be sent an email with the information.
I want to say this style of bookbinding is called Australian.
Possibly. I think so. I think that's what we did.
An Australian bookbind? Anybody know the name? Why do I feel like it's an Australian bookbind? Ooh, an exercise and the project will be a different part. That's cool. Also, make your own pages. Make your own PDF pages and create your own book for whatever you do. If you have the recipe card builder stamp set, build your own recipe sections. That would be really cool. And I'll talk to you about some more functionalities in a few minutes, which I think are really cool. Can't show you that till I get it all built. So keep going. I can show you because we did it this morning. But this was the plan. So you've got 10 projects in here. Now, what I love about it is, first off, it lays perfectly flat. There were several things I wanted. I wanted it to lay flat. That was one thing. And the second thing I wanted was to be able to add pages and remove pages. And you can do both of those here, okay? And I'm going to show you this. You will be able to, at the end, when you get this all made, if you want to add pages after the fact, you can absolutely cut this away from its chipboard backing and use that, take the last page out and access your binder here and just continue your rosette out. So if you're like, man, I just need two more projects in that book. If I had two more, like if you wanted to do 12 projects, if I had two more projects in there, you could just add a little bit more binding, which I love. And if you're like me and you have a really bad handwriting, you can absolutely, I cut one extra because I knew I would mess up. So I just cut one extra and I didn't need it. You can remove and change and pull out. That's what I love. That's this one. We did this one earlier today. You can just come in here and like, maybe I don't like this project I was working on. I can do this. And you've got the free printable. Take it out. Put on a new one. I love it. Maybe you like to take your pages out and put them where your work surface is. And see, this is one that I did not do the corner rounding on. And I do think the corner rounding makes it easier to push through. But again, the trick is baby pushes. You do not want to try to do big pushes because it bends the bottom.
Heidi, you can ask questions. If you have a question, you can just post it.
Now, I don't love my spine this time.
Shirley, I see you posted a 2. Let me know what your question is or if you just need us to slow down for a second.
That's slick. I like that. That's slick. Yeah, I want y'all to think about this, okay? those of you who can design projects like this, this can all be made different sizes. So maybe you want to do a half book, then just edit it down to half. You see what I'm saying? Maybe you want it to be on this. You want your bind to, your spine to be on this end and have a book that opens this way. You can still use this, the same situation. It's an accordion fold and some strips. That's how it works. Now, what I'm going to do here is, my question was, do you skip a page? You don't skip a page. You go to every mountain.
Yeah.
It does automatically, but you just got to make sure every mountain, every other page doesn't have a mountain.
If you glue anything to the strip, you're not going to be able to take the page back off unless it fits between that.
As long as you glue it here.
Yeah. As long as it doesn't go above the spine, I guess I'm trying to say, mm-hmm. you'll be able to take it off.
As long as you glue, say this is, as long as you glue it to that, to the outside, you're golden. That's a good idea. Good way to put pockets into your pages. Super cute. All right. Now all we're going to do, whatever your front is and whatever your back is that you cut, you'll just glue those on. Now, I know some of you, not everyone, I know some of you are very picky about covering your chipboard and stuff. If you want to go back and make a new one and do this differently, go right ahead. Mine's not going to cover my edges. I'm not stressed about that. You can ink your edges, whatever. If your cardstock cut is not perfect, take your nail file when you glue this down and file it down to make it match. There's so many ways to do that, but I would just glue this down because this is going to be a working, I don't feel like, or at least this one I'm doing right now, is not going to be a memory keeper. This is going to be a project keeper. So I'm not too awful worried about it being perfection. It'll be cute. That's why I use the craft paper. I thought it would be cute to use that craft paper line.
Yep.
Squish. This paper is the...
We still have it in stock. It is...
Happy Crafting. It's so cute, you guys. And look at all these cut-aparts and stickers. Let me just show you some of it. Look how cute.
It's really cute paper.
We have some in store. It's not a whole lot in store right now, but there is some in store. Look at it. Also, it's Cartabella, so it's lovely.
Absolutely. Happy Crafting. It's so pretty.
Love it. All right, let me finish. And now Shannon will have a book, and I'll have a book, because now we have two.
Woohoo!
Oh, you could use this for what you're working on right now. Okay. And we could use it for that. Oh, I love that idea. I think I'm going to. We could use it for the other thing we're working on right now. Thing? Yeah, the thing. That thing.
Are we thinking about the same thing?
The thing thing.
The thing thing thing?
Mm-hmm. That one. Yeah.
The thing we did pictures of?
Yeah. Okay. And also the other thing that we also forgot about till yesterday when we were explaining it to Brenda.
Oh, that thing.
Yeah. I'm going to use it for that. So I'm going to use one book for that and one book for that. Oh, the yellow would be pretty in there. And Missy would really like this because she's into yellow.
She loves yellow.
But I'm going to use these guys.
I like those guys too. It's a pretty paper. Excuse me, guys.
It smells amazing. Yes, it does. Endorphins. Have to tell y'all, I was a little down last week. I was having kind of a emotional, grumpy downness. Just that's what it was. Emotional, grumpy downness. Anybody ever have that?
Yep.
And I hadn't been to Rustic in a while to just walk around and shop. But I have a shelf there. It's not a booth. I have a shelf where I sell some things there, and I had to go restock it. And so it was real quiet. It was late one afternoon. It was real quiet in there. And I started walking around the store, and all of a sudden I felt my mood lift, like felt it lift up. And I was like, oh, so Rustic gives me endorphins. Like Rustic makes me feel good. And that's what this does.
Ice cream.
It's like ice cream, gluing things and stuff. You know, you just made your little project book, you guys. Isn't it stinking cute and easy to do? You just did it.
It can be used for so many things.
Now, right now, because we we have plenty of time. If you have a question or if you struggle with something, let's answer struggle questions real quick. If you had something you wanted to ask, typically, let me say this. Typically, once you've seen a project from start to finish, your questions get answered. It's when we just start something like this that kind of leaves us with a lot of questions. Yay! It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun. Oh, I messed up. I got these again.
You could attach a ribbon before you cover the mat, the outside of your chipboard, if you wanted to tie it closed.
Okay, so let's do our first giveaway. I'm going to try something I've not tried before. So I'm going to tell you about it before I tell you what to do. So with the software that we use to stream, we have the opportunity to, it has a built-in giveaway tool, and I want to use that today. The giveaway tool allows me to be able to give you a word, and you type that word into the chat, and then the giveaway tool will capture everyone who types that word, and it does a random drawing for us, which we'll be able to see that happen. So that's really cool, okay? So we're going to do a giveaway for everyone watching live. But if you're not watching live, if you're watching the replay, if you'll go to the description of the video, we have a rafflecopter link. We're also going to give away the same prize to someone watching the replay, okay? So it'll really be two giveaways. Now, you cannot win twice. So if the winner is watching live and they win, and then the person enters and the same person is drawn, you won't get the prize twice, okay? So we want to make sure it's fair for everybody. So we'll have two prizes, one for if you're watching live and one for if you're watching the replay. And we will not let the same person win twice. That's only fair, okay? All right, let me show you what the prize is. And then I'll tell you what the word is. I'm not going to tell you the word yet.
Somebody asked, what do your center strips do once you get them through the mountains? They're just there.
They hold your pages in.
She didn't do anything to them. They're just there. A couple people have said their white pages stick out. What can they do?
Stick out.
Like, it's not even.
At the top? Do that. Tap them. And if they're not even here and that bothers you, you can just cut those off with like a blade and a ruler. I wouldn't stress about it. I'd let it ride. I really would. The book is pretty fluid, you know, and the more you hold it and play with it, kind of the more it gets fluid. I wouldn't stress. Also, if you want to make your next one where this is a little bit bigger, you can do that too. You can make this a little further out.
And your spine cuts, if you flip it, you can see hers has a little extra. If you make sure it has, they'll adjust on the spine.
Like mine are, yeah, I gave you wiggle room, but that's so that you wouldn't be sad. If I gave you perfect measures, you'd be like, this didn't
They'll
work.
Be everywhere.
This is the way to do it. All right, let me show you the prize. Was that the only one?
I think so. Those are the only ones I saw.
So today's prize, it's just kind of a random conglomeration of things. I thought we'd do this in honor of Shannon. She loves the green. So I'm going to give away a green cup.
Don't know what you mean.
Oh, you have yours today. That's awesome. I'm going to give away a green cup. Okay. And like I said, it's the same prize for those watching later. So the green cup, this is a prize package. So hold on. I'm going to give away a green impressible. Now, if you're watching after today, if you do the replay giveaway, that one is black and it's a little bit different here, but it's pretty similar. So green impressible. If you don't know what these are, they're super fun. I have videos on them. I'm going to give away this perfectly ready for spring pack of ribbon. Come on. Don't we all need this? So ready for spring, isn't it? Love this. So give away that. And then I'm going to give away some spring markers. These are Nuvo. They come in their little container. They're beautiful spring colors. So that's the package that you'll be entering for today. So it's all of these items. The cup comes in a box, so I put it back in there. Okay. So if you would like to enter and you're watching live, if you're watching the replay, you have to go enter in the description. It won't work the same, so you don't have to put this in. But if you're watching live, type the word. Let me say this. It's all lowercase. All lowercase. Type the word crafty. Type the word crafty.
I don't get to enter, do I?
You do not. And you can see here how many entries are going in. Do you see we've got 33 that quick? It captures all of your entries when you type the word crafty. And
Thanks
then once everybody's through typing crafty, we'll let it draw for us. see how many entries we get today. There's 664 people watching. So let's see if we can get 664 entries. That would be really cool. Sorry, microphone folks, that came on quick. I apologize. Look, 221 entries.
Crafty, all lowercase. I see a couple capital C's going in there. So make sure it's all lowercase.
It needs to look like that word on the screen. I like this feature.
That's pretty cool. I didn't even realize it was there. Wow. I'm
blind. You see it on the screen? Isn't that cool?
I do see it on the screen now.
252. I mean, everybody doesn't have to enter, but I'm saying we're going to let it go until I feel like, till it stops jumping. 264. If you're watching live and you're the word crafty, you can win our little bundle here. And I've got the markers, the spring colored ribbons, the impressible, and the green cup. I don't like it in the box.
And you only have to enter once.
Yeah, it'll only, actually, I'm glad you said that.
It only lets you enter once.
It'll only take your name once. So if you type it multiple times, it blocks it. It only takes one entry, which I think is so awesome.
Yeah.
So only type one time to be entered. 284. All right, the clock says 11:16. So at 11:18, we'll hit draw. That gives a minute and a half at least. At 11:18, we'll hit draw. So yeah, I hope you enjoy that. And like I said, we're going to be giving this away. If you're watching in the after show, if you're watching the replay, you want to go to the description. There's a link to a rafflecopter giveaway. You want to enter there. You do have to answer a question in the rafflecopter, and the question correlates with cups. Say your favorite color. We're going to try to give you your favorite color cup. I can't promise because they might sell out before I get there, but I put cup colors in there so you could pick. But green is one of the options if you want it. It's still 11:16 on my calendar.
On your calendar?
My calendar says 11:16.
It's a nice calendar you got there.
There's a lot of capital C's. It may accept the capital. I don't know, but I put it on the screen so y'all could see it. So what about people who didn't realize it went in as capital C? Then type it again as small C and it'll either take it or it won't. It may take the capital. I don't know. But I would just type it again. If you typed capital, just type it again.
Yeah, it's only going to accept one of your entries. Mm-hmm. So I'm just telling you, I was just trying to tell you, you don't have to type it multiple times.
Yeah. And you got another minute, not quite a minute, because we're into a minute. How many entries? 309. That's cool.
Super cool. 311. 313. 15. Seventeen.
Get ready. Kathy, it doesn't matter if they're white on one side, because those pieces are just going to hold the pages in. It doesn't matter.
Nope.
You could even use that white side to make notes or something. It'd be super cool. All right. It's 11:18. I'm going to hit the button. I want to hit the button, but people are still typing.
327.
It's still moving, so I'm not going to leave anybody out, but I'm not going to sit here all day. We can't do that.
328. Going once.
Oh, 329.
330.
All right. I'm not going to watch the numbers. When my clock changes to 319, that's it. I mean, 1119, that's it.
All right.
I'm not watching. I'm just going to hit the button as soon as my computer changes to 11:19.
If you didn't get to enter this one,
you can do the rafflecopter. Coming in late,
you can do the rafflecopter.
Yeah. Oh, the rafflecopter, by the way, won't go live until noon today. I have it set up to go. All right, 11:19, I'm hitting the button.
Oh, look at this. This is so cool.
I love it. Look, my hands are in the air. I want y'all to see. I'm not doing this.
I'm not doing it either.
This is not us. Yeah. That's so cute. I love it. Patricia, look how pretty you are in your picture.
Pretty.
Patricia, you won.
Congratulations, Patricia.
Show us you're here by saying yay or something. And what you'll need to do, Patricia, is you'll need to email Shannon.
Yes, please.
Your mailing address. We probably have it. You probably could just pull it, but just go ahead and email your mailing address so that we'll know that you got it. There she is. Yay, Patricia. Yay, Patricia. Good job. That was awesome. I love that. Y'all might see that a lot more often. I like when That's we can do fun. Things easy. All right. So again, if you're watching after the club is over, just go ahead and enter the rafflecopter that's in the description of the video that you're watching. It goes live at noon today. Very good, Patricia. All these goodies are coming to you. Patricia, if you would like a different color cup, if you go on the website and look at what's available and you want to tell Shannon what color you'd like, I'd rather you have the color you want. Because, like, I mean, I love this green, but you might want a different color. So just let her know. It's fine. We can switch it out.
More green for me.
I think there's white, coral. I don't remember the other colors. I know the green, white, and coral are available because I didn't look at anything else. But just go look and see. All right. That's it, you guys. How fun. Did you enjoy this? I can't believe how much we got done, and it's 11:20, and we even had to do all that prep, all that pre-work in the beginning, all that chatter that we had to do. So I'm pretty happy about that. I hope that was fun, you guys. I can't wait till our next project, and to let you know what it is, it's going to be our make-in mail that comes out the last Thursday of this month, and ironically, it's the 29th. It'll come out on the 29th. Oh, by the way, if you're entering the rafflecopter giveaway, we're going to let that one stay open until the 28th, and I'll announce that winner in the video of the 29th. So that's how we'll do the after show ones. So, because that gives people time to watch it when they can. So if you're live, you enter now, and if you're watching the after show, go ahead and enter that rafflecopter, and we'll announce that winner in the last Thursday video. All right, don't forget we have a live show tonight. Please be there. And if you're there, if you're in the live show tonight, then in the chat, I want you to type the word gum.
Tamitha said the tumblers are drafted.
Oh, are
so
they?
So if you kind of know what color you might want, message me, Patricia, and I'll or
there's
email
only
me.
A few colors.
Yeah.
Can you I'll look at them real quick and tell her?
Let you know.
That, yeah, just do that. But honestly, if you're in the live show tonight, then the show tonight starts at 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. If you come to that show, I want you to type the word gum. I want to show Vinny how many people participated this morning. So even if you watch the after show, if you watch this later, like if you're not watching live, tonight type gum. As soon as you get in there, gum. Yeah?
Gum.
I think that'll be funny. I think it'll be funny.
Gum.
All right, you guys, we love you so much. We've enjoyed every second of this. If you need anything, reach out. Now, let me tell you something. With our emails being so weird right now, we have found a little bit of a workaround. So if you've been looking for emails from Shannon, you're starting to get them. But if worst case scenario, you can go to our maymaymadeit.com site. And in the bottom corner, we have a need help. You can live chat with Haley if you need to. Okay, if email's not working, go right there and you can always call us too. All right, you guys. Oh, where's the thumbs up? Somebody said. Did nobody give all the thumbs up? You guys got to Vinny the video today and tonight. So make sure you do, okay? We love you so much. We will see you next month for another fun club. And we'll see you in the chat rooms between now and then. All right, have a great one. We'll see you tonight. Bye now.